Good morning and welcome. It's the midweek edition of Wake Up Nigeria. Of course, it's the 13th day in the third month of 2024th year of our Lord. It is great to have you this morning. Welcome.
Definitely. It's a brand new day. We're definitely here to give you brand new inspiration. Brand new, of course, it's a midweek. So midweek, you need to actually like kick stars, right? Yeah. Start afresh and just revive your week.
I love this part.
And make sure. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank it's going to be a wonderful show we have in store for you today. My name is Mike Messikeno.
My name is Winfrey Agbelesha. Now, do not forget, you can definitely join the conversation on social media at TVC Entertainment _ on Twitter, X, Facebook, in fact, on all social media platforms.
Definitely. It's going to be a great show we have in store for you. Remember, you can hit us up online. It's TVC Entertainment on YouTube. That's where you can watch us if you're watching on terrestrial. It's ultra high frequency. 49 is the band. And of course, if it's on DTT, that will be GOTV channel 16.
Yes,
let's get straight into what we have this morning.
Yes, and we have, we're starting off with nutrition today, and we have Osusanya Olajumoke, who is a registered dietitian, nutritionist, and the founder of Cairo Diet Clinic, renowned for providing medical nutrition therapy, and to commemorate World Dietitians Day. Ooh. She will be discussing dietitians. Who are they and why should you consult them?
World Dietitians Day. I'm looking forward to that one because diet is a very, very important part of how we live, of our culture and all of that. And, you know, growing up, I didn't used to hear about dietitians, but now
but
it's become
now,
more important.
It's a thing, of course.
Exactly.
Because people are conscious of their health, and that's amazing.
Thing. Yeah. All right, of course. And then we also have a performance, an artist. We have Elus. A standout upcoming artist who blends Nigerian rhythms with a spice of R&B performing this morning.
Eloho Efemina is a certified clinical counselor and mental health coach. Eloho actively works to build the self-worth and esteem of young girls and women enduring fear, shame, and guilt due to past or present sexual, verbal, or physical abuse. And she'll be discussing the negative effects of a broken marriage on children and how to handle it.
Cheetah. It's really women's month. Meanwhile, Alpha, women's day, we now do nothing, now just day like that. You don't know how about the men that support women? I don't get our time, Abi.
How do you mean?
The men that support women.
How do you mean? Is there something specifically you're asking for?
You would just package just arrange yourself. Just did by yourself, by yourself, by yourself.
There are men supporting women in this women's month.
There are men that support women more than that women support women meet that people carry around.
It's not a myth.
Yes.
I tell you
that we men, there are many of us that support women even more than women have the ability to.
I agree with you, Mike. You were very supportive, and I want to say thank you so much. Your support has been
it's not by mouth. But I'm sure you guys had fun. I know you had events. I know you had events and all of that. And yeah, it's so the whole month was celebrating women, of course. And it was good, especially when I was watching some part of the Oscars. Incidentally, I watched it live, so there was no light, and the light just came at about that time. And then somehow I tuned in, and it was Oscars. And there was the actress who received the best supporting actress, which was a black lady. She was on the plus side, and she said something. She said she had always wanted to be like other people, but what she needed to be was to be herself. And it was all mushy and all that. So I would get the name, but yeah, I know later on Friday we'll talk about movies that won at the Oscars. But yeah, that was a big moment for me, and of course for all women to celebrate women's month.
By the way,
Sunday was not Mother's. It was Mothering Sunday in some countries. The mother owns on me. Good morning. The news on Wake Up Nigeria. I'm Mike Messikeno. Now, the Senate has suspended yesterday Senator Abdul Ningi, representing Bauchi Central, for making false allegations of budget padding to the tune of 3.7 trillion naira. Now, this is as the Senate also cautioned the lawmaker representing Kano South, Sumaila Akawo, to refrain from posting items capable of causing division and breakdown of law and order. However,
the upper legislative chamber in its resolutions offered to give Senator Nengi a soft landing, provided he tenders an unreserved apology through a letter addressed to the Senate, and it will be delivered by other lawmakers for further legislative action. National Assembly correspondent TJ Su Adeoye reports.
Against the presidency and the Nigerian Senate for allegedly padding of the 2024 budget to the tune of 3.7 trillion naira. Rising under Senate standing orders, Chairman of the Senate's Committee on Appropriations, Senator Olamileka, claims there is a breach of his constitutional privileges in the interview granted by Senator Nengi. The chairman goes to explain that the 3.7 trillion naira in question is for statutory transfers to government agencies on first-line charge.
There are agencies of the government whose budgets and their details are not contained in these two documents because they are statutory agencies and their money are on first-line charge. Agencies such as, one, the judiciary. The judiciary budget details is not contained in this document. Two, the National Assembly. The National Assembly budget details is not contained in this document.
President of the Senate throws the floor open to other lawmakers to contribute to the matter, including the man in the eye of the storm, Abdul Nengi. He was also given his right to be heard.
This is a fake contribution that was forwarded. I do not know the author of this.
Senator Jaribe, in his contributions, also stirred the hornet's nest with another allegation of 500 million naira he claimed was given to senators for execution of projects, but he later made some amendments and clarifications to his allegations.
If he got 500 million extra, he is culpable. He is not supposed to be accusing others that they got 100 billion, 500 billion. There was nothing like that in the budget. If you go through the budget, you will not see anybody getting 100 billion anywhere. That is the position. The Senate did not get anything like that. He got extra 500 million in the budget for projects in his place, not the rest of us. That was my position. And I also said that there was Senator Yayi, the chairman of profession, has cleared the air of whatever insinuations there were. So there was no padding of 3.7 billion, and that's my position.
After much talk, the Senate resolved to suspend Senator Abdul Nengi from all activities of the National Assembly for 3 months, including withdrawing all his entitlement, and mandated him to stay away from the National Assembly premises.
Those in support of the suspension for 3 months say aye.
Aye.
Those against say nay.
The upper legislative chamber also gave the lawmaker a chance to tender a written apology to the Senate, which will be subject to the consideration of lawmakers for further legislative action.
This may not be the end of the matter, and it may also not be the end of the turbulence in the Senate. But the Senate's leadership have succeeded in showing the public that all allegations of padding are untrue, and in the process further heightened the tension that already exists in the red chambers. TJ Su Adeoye, TVC News.
Haiti's Prime Minister Ariel Henry has agreed to resign following weeks of mounting pressure and increasing violence in the impoverished country. It comes after regional leaders met in Jamaica on Monday to discuss a political transition in Haiti. Mr. Henry is currently stranded in Puerto Rico after being prevented by armed gangs from returning home. He led the country supposedly on an interim basis since July 2021, following former President Jovenel Moïse's assassination, and had repeatedly postponed elections, saying security must be restored first. Many Haitians had questioned him governing the country for this long without an elected president. Heavily armed gangs have tightened their grip on the streets of the capital, Port-au-Prince, and attacked the main prison to help thousands of inmates escape. They also demanded the resignation of the unelected prime minister. We'll take a time out, stay with us. When we get back, the show gets started. Wednesday. Well, it's the middle of the week. And of course, a good way to start your day is to exercise. Now, the problem is that a lot of people have not been exercising because of the heat. Because when you wake up, the normal exercise that you said that will bring heat, there's already heat before. So how do you want to start to exercise? Well,
in spite of all that happens, find a way to move around. At least when you get to work, don't be in a sedentary position. All right, so MM and, of course, Danny are here with me. And I saw this yesterday. First of all, I didn't even know that Rita Dominic quit acting, per se. Because, I don't know, I do... Okay, well, we know and all, but I didn't
notice.
You
didn't see it as quitting. You thought it was just taking a break.
I didn't even know it was taking a break because, you know, there's some of these A-list actresses, choose maybe projects they do. They they're not in so many projects like that. And then somebody just after a while is the person. Mm. So, you know, but then she was at an event or something. And this was posted. It cut away from the event. And she said something that many of us didn't know. And she said that she quit acting because she fell out with some friends turned family, or friends who she thought were family. She fell out with them and the environment wasn't conducive again. So you know what happens? Probably those some people that, you know, they have some level of influence in that particular sphere. And said she had to go to the UK to, you know, detox from the environment, as it were. And she had to resort to caregiving to fend for herself. And she said that was not a problem because she had cared for her parents and she loves caring for people. Mm. And then people go, oh, you know, a lot of comments about, oh, she had to, as if caregiving, it's as a, it were, is condescending.
It
is,
yeah.
And this is off. I don't know if you saw an interview with Femi Brainard. Femi Brainard, who spoke about how he went to the US and had to drive, ride share to survive. And it seemed, and then many people just go as if, is there no longer dignity in labor? That's where I want to come from. Because everybody feels that, Rita, I'm only going to do caregiving. That's a very major step down. Femi went to do e-hailing. Femi, you know, that's one angle, but With all of this, for me it was a shocking revelation. But she said she did it not just about being fending for herself, but something that she loves to do.
She loves to do.
How did that make you feel? I mean, thinking about all of that, is it condescending, as it were, for a celebrity to go and look for a job or do something when not being in the limelight, as it were? Because there were a lot of comments and different angles from different places and all that. But for me, man, that's why I wouldn't want to start from myself. Kudos, man. Rita, my respect for you. Stepped up a notch.
Okay, I saw the video yesterday, and to be honest, it sort of warmed my heart.
Okay.
It actually warmed my heart, and it's not because of what she had to do when she traveled or when she took that break, you know, from acting. It's, you know, bearing that part of herself with the world, you know. People in this climb didn't know what happened until she shared that part of her. And I'm sure it must have taken so much from her for her to have shared it because of people's perception, right? And let's not also forget that the celebrity, the word celebrity, you know, sometimes I feel like it's all in our head. What is or who is a celebrity?
Somebody who's celebrated.
Yeah, someone who's celebrated in a certain field or industry, right?
Yeah, level of influence or something.
Yeah, who also wields some level of influence and in some cases is seen as a role model. I think there are so many lessons to take from her story.
From this.
I think that's what we should dwell on, not what she did when she was
away
from the industry.
You know why I even want to? Because she spoke about, she actually... spoke about what she did because she said there's nothing bigger than caring for humans. And for me, I tell people, look, after God, number two, now doctors, care for human beings for me is top tier there.
Yeah.
So she actually majored on that because it's for those who are passionate about it. I remember when the caregiver came here, the passion with which she was talking, it's a higher calling. You're not, at times, it's not even about, the money might be good, you know, but then it's about caring for your fellow human beings. And that's the big one there for me. And, you know, it made me ask, if something happened and you have to leave what you're doing, what you're earning and all that, what would you fall back on? What is that thing that you do? Yeah, I don't go. Yeah, what's that thing that you do that maybe people might feel might be condescending, but maybe a handwork or something that you could do and you'll be fine doing it.
Let's not also forget that caregivers earn so much outside of this country. They earn a lot of monies. Yeah. Because of the level of or the capacity at which they need to, you know, function in that level. They earn a lot of money. So it's not a small, so I can imagine how much you would have even earned in maybe a month compared to how much
people,
you would have earned.
People you are taking care of
as an actor here.
They are probably retired. So they have their pension, their savings
there, and they want you to take them, so they enter all of that. So you're getting well compensated for doing one of the best jobs on earth,
even though it's kind of very hard. She actually mentioned and put indeed that it was caregiving.
Yes,
like,
you know, she emphasized
when,
on it.
Exactly, when this person almost can do nothing for themselves.
Yeah.
So you basically have to almost do
She even used the word incontinent. That's to further emphasize, you know, the states at which, you know, some of those older people are at, you know, are in, basically. So, yeah.
What would you do? I mean, if you make hair or something, what would you do?
She already makes clothes now. What again?
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. You just continue making clothes.
I think it's just in Nigeria, right, that we put some value, or that we overemphasize certain roles, right? Here, I mean, everyone in the professional field, in career strata, right, they want to always, like, level up. And there's nothing wrong with that. However, it's in Nigeria that we literally will take position, right, and title over things that really matter, like even earning more, right? You see someone who would rather sit down in Nigeria and be bank manager. As a celebrity, we're talking about how much caregivers actually earn over there. They actually earn more than the celebrities
over here.
Right here. Do you understand? Most of these celebrities, what even give them maybe like that kind of money, maybe it's like influencing for like major companies here and all of that. But the other ones that are literally creating a facade and living a certain type of lifestyle, we all know that it's not based on the work of maybe acting and all of that. Because really, how much does Nigerian acting, or how much does he really pay? Do you understand? So, and I feel when it comes to, I know what I'm saying now, influencing now for like major gigs and brands and all of that. And then I also feel that beyond even finances, right? So here as well, we put a lot of value on how we look, what we own, and all those kind of things, forgetting the humanity of it all. What is that actual thing you do that brings you fulfillment? And whether you like it or not, even like generally, they tell you when you're feeling down, compliment somebody. It's actually that service to another person that actually has the effect of giving you that honest fulfillment. Do you understand? That's why even when we when like we see like the billionaires, most of the time they probably give like half of their wealth to charity and like do
that's
things that are that's honestly where you find real fulfillment. So
and
we need to start thinking about things. And then when it comes to caregiving, the way she spoke about it, right? The gravity of it.
Yeah.
When we think about it, it's not everyone that has a heart.
It's not.
That's why she said she loves it. Do you understand? It's not everybody that can stand it. Whether I like it or not,
it's
right?
Not.
So
I have the heart, but I can't stand it. I would love to take care of it because someday it's a blessing to get old. So someday everybody will always be there.
Of course,
I was watching this movie Oppenheimer, and then I looked at it and I'm like, look, you're 13 today. Tomorrow you'll be 31. Next tomorrow you'll be 70.
Yeah.
But she said to him, what would you do if you had to something handy? What would you do?
Something handy. What will I don't know.
If you were not doing all of this, the glam and all that was not there, what would you do? What would you fall back on?
Even now, I teach.
That is something that
I actually enjoy doing.
I love that. I want to be. And that is why, that's probably the only reason why I want to further education, just to be able to bequeath
teach
and impart
and
knowledge.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. What are your thoughts? Let's know what you think. Hit us up, TVC Entertainment _. Let's know your thoughts on Rita Dominic. For me, I would say there is dignity in labor.
Yeah, regardless of what you're doing.
If you're not stealing, if you're not doing something wrong,
honest,
no matter what it is,
labor,
dignity in labor. All right, we'll take a time out. Stay with us. We'll be back in a bit.
Thank you so much for staying with us. You're still watching Wake Up Nigeria on this beautiful, beautiful Wednesday morning. And right now, it's time for us to take what we have on the cover of the dailies. And over here, I have the Daily Times, I have the Vanguard, I have Daily Trust, and New Telegraph. I also have Mike right here with me.
Oh, you introduce the paper first before you introduce me. Do the paper.
I'm not doing it again. Oh, yeah, sorry. I have Mike here.
Okay.
First, okay, so let me see. Let me start off with the Daily Times. And here for the major headlines, we have Tinubu meets Akpabio over Ninge's suspension. And we have at the top left over there, I won't dump PDP, says Atiku. We have that on page 2. Abuja market sets ablaze as police bullet kills suspects. We have that on page 2 as well. To the right of that, we have play 2. Governor bans open grazing. We have that on page 2. Below that, we have stocks market sustained winning streak, gains 836.58 billion naira. And on the bottom there, we have the National Assembly receives Abuja's 2024 budget proposal. ETI gets $250 million senior bridge to bond loan facility to support trade. We have that on page 2 as well. Mike.
Yeah, of course, the major headline there.
Yes.
We're talking about it in the news. And they say the president meets the Senate president over the suspension of Senator Ningi. And it's quite interesting for me. This is very simple. If he has made that allegation, then an audit should be carried out on the finances of the National Assembly. It's not even up for discussion.
Of course, definitely.
And the president has also spoken about it. I mean, you saw what happened with the Minister of Humanitarian Affairs and
Better
Edu, who, you know, with all, for me, in just a very, very, how many months, auntie has entered and... She has a target.
Yeah, she has a...
You understand?
She has
so
a
my
goal.
Point is that it should extend to everybody. That, you understand? And if the Senate, if such an allegation, and budget pardon is something that... at different times, we've spoken about how budgets have been padded. People have made this sort of allegation. So we should look into it. We should have an audit. To be truthful, if you get an external auditing firm to find out, it's going to be very, very easy to know and see it. And so, you know, I would love to know what comes out of all of this. Of course, Senator Ningi was given an option to apologize, as it were. And they should do the audit.
Step down straight before anything else. Really, while the audit is being done, the first thing, you cannot be in that position and literally have such allegation and still be in. Step down first. Then
I mean,
we'll
it happens around
move.
The world.
Yes, of course.
Even leaders around there.
The fact that your integrity is being questioned at that level in trillions, not.
Yeah, 3 trillion and all of that. And as the president of the Senate, the responsibility is on you. There will be something like that being operated without you. So, yes, 100% with you on that one, Winfrey.
Yeah, so for what I love the fact that, I mean, we're seeing things like this come out.
Do
you understand? I love the fact that...
He made mention, said, look, some of the senior senators took 500 million.
Yes.
And he said, I didn't get it. I was a ranking senator, but the senior members... And then that would have angered some people,
yes,
I'm sure.
Yes, of course. I mean, it's the flippancy for me, though, if you ask me. It's just the flippancy for me. It's like there's no regard for your state, for your office, for the federation. It's quite... I mean, considering everything that's actually happening with the world, in Nigeria, economy,
at the moment.
And all of that, it's terrible. So I think you have the vanguard.
Yeah, okay. Let's see. Rumpus, senators beak over money sharing. That's basically headline across all the papers this morning.
Yes.
This is on the vanguard, alleged budget padding. Adekoya OPC hunters mobilized as Governor Adeleke uncovers plots to attack schools and farms in Osun State. Africa Games Nigeria. Saw us to number 2, overtakes Algeria and South Africa. That's talking about sports there. Atiku denies dumping PDP and slams Tinubu. Quite interesting there. I would normally say that a healthy polity is one that has a healthy opposition.
Opposition,
so,
yes, of course. Keeps you on your toes.
Exactly. It is a good thing. FG postpones students' loan scheme indefinitely. Threats to life. Bauchi governor apologizes to Tinubu's wife. Quite interesting there. That's it. That's it. On it's the same thing here. Abapa gridlock.
Yes.
Lagos government impounds over 75 trucks. 2023 presidential poll, most divisive in Nigeria's history. That's Vice President Shettima. And Edo gubernatorial, APC may settle for Ogbede Ihama as running mate to Okpebolo. That is top right corner. And of course it is the same thing here. Senators, big queen of our money sharing. That is not what you were elected to do. That you are there as a servant. I mean, I think the time we make these things less glamorous and understand that people that you're going there to serve. And not to enrich yourself and set yourself up and your generation or whatever for life. We need to understand that. We need to understand that as a people.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's it.
I feel for the longest time, right? I think that is honestly what it has been. People just see these positions as an opportunity for them to literally step ahead. Do you understand? And that's why there's so much rancor whenever it comes to, okay, fine, filling those slots. That's why people seem to literally, I mean, we all know Nigerian senators now. We know them. Anyways, moving on to the Daily Trust right here. For the major headlines, we have 500 million just tier senators apart. Okay, for the writers, we have Ningi suspended for 3 months, quits as Northern Senators chair. Nigerians will never respect Senate in future.
You respect them in the past.
That's all. Leader alleges plots to impeach Senate president. And that's all amid budget padding allegations. And of course, to the top left there, we have bandits kidnapped 30 villagers in Kaduna, returned to Kuruga 5 days after. We have 2024 Hajj pilgrims in limbo as Nakon yet to remit funds. Okay, we have that on page 25. And of course, below there, we have more breezes, Abuja market, as prison officers gone down fleeing suspects. We have that on page 6. And below there to the left, we have Niger residents' fault, renaming of Abubakar Imam International Airport. We have that on page 24. Sokoto abductors of Sagaya students demand 20 million ransom. We have that on page 7. African Games, Nigeria secures second position with 6 more gold medals. Okay, I feel, I mean.
That's all that we should be able to take on the paper. But just talking about the games, you're talking about.
Yes, medals. I was actually going to ask
it's all Africa games, and many people do not know so much about it, but it's basically like continental Olympics, mm-hmm. as it were. Mm-hmm. That is what it is. Mm-hmm. And so Nigerians are. I think we're second overall. I don't know the exact number. And the reason why I don't know the exact number of medals is that we have a terrible, terrible attitude towards record keeping.
Okay.
So you can't... Normally, if it is the Olympics, you have the Olympic site where you go where every second it's updated,
yes.
as it were. We don't have that for the All-Africa
Games. Wow.
There's a site, but there is no way we can get the updated medal list as it goes
as
on.
It is.
Apart from the fact that we can't even see a lot of these events to watch.
To watch, yes.
You know,
yes,
so, true. You know, this continent, we get a lot to do, man. And these are things that in this day and age of technology where it's so easy
actually do that, yeah. You just need to put one person on it, one sharp person on it to actually do all of that. I mean, it's tech, but I think that's where we struggle.
I can do it.
Yeah, you can do it. Yeah. I think the PR for the All-African Games is also not as strong.
At all.
Right? It's not necessary.
Terrible.
You definitely have to work on that. I don't know if you have time for the final paper. Okay, and that's all we'll be taking on the newspaper headlines for today. We have our chef Yawo and MM standing by in the kitchen. What's cooking, guys?
Yes, Sawa Iyawo in the making. Oh, okay. She needed to remind you guys that she has been taking. Welcome, Chef Blossom.
Thank you, Emma.
All right. So this morning she came to literally pepper us, like literally.
Yes.
Not with her ring, but also with her cooking this morning. The weather is hot, Blossom.
Okay, let me not say what I have in mind.
Okay, please. So this morning, Blossom will be making pepper soup.
Catfish pepper soup,
yes, to be precise. And this is actually my favorite kind of protein when it comes to fish.
Yeah.
And my favorite kind of pepper soup, actually, because, you know, it's catfish. There's a certain kind of flavor catfish actually gives to whatever
that's
you...
That's feeling.
Yeah, the taste. And you want to know my favorite part of the fish? You want
the
to
head.
Guess? The head.
I think
yes, and I am very unapologetic about it, guys. You see
why
that head?
You like the head?
I will consume it, like literally consume it. Let's talk about the ingredients for our recipe this morning.
Okay, so today I decided to go very simple. As you can see, I have my crayfish, onions, pepper soup spice, some seasoning, some stock powder. This is called hot pepper, hot local pepper. Hmm.
The green
you find it in Oyinbo market. Yes, and then we have some plantain to serve as thickener and to give it some extra
flavor.
Sweetness. Yes, mm-hmm. Then we'll go with our scent leaf, and I'd like to add some extra leave. This is called your utazi leave.
Oh, utazi. Okay.
Yes, utazi leave. Mm. Just to give you that bitter, sour, you know?
Just a good balance.
Yeah,
basically.
Good balance, yeah.
Because, I mean, like, you have the sweetness from the plantain, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. and then you have, like, the extra,
even
extra
from the
flavor
fish.
From the fish.
Yes.
Then you have the utazi leaf to balance mm-hmm, out to balance on everything.
So our star ingredients, the catfish.
Yes, the catfish.
Should I talk more about this fish?
Go ahead, please.
You guys, you don't want to buy catfish now. just settle with Pamela.
She said you don't want to.
You don't want to. So I was, okay. I'd already, if not that I'd already sent my menu,
I would have said,
let's do pomo. Because, guys, things are extremely expensive now.
And you know what? I was even about to ask you how much you bought your pepper. Because pepper now in the market, it's gold, people.
Yes.
It's gold. First off, it's hard to find, and then it's very expensive. Mm-hmm. I remember sending my girl to the market over, like, yesterday or 2 days ago, and you see tomato, pepper, onions. They are saying...
I think onions is out now.
But it's expensive.
Quite expensive compared to how it was about last week.
I agree. Mm-hmm, not just about last week, like 2 months ago.
Yeah.
Okay, so yes, Chef Blossom is making catfish pepper soup. Let's run through the ingredients, just basically to remind people what we're making, what we're working with, and over to you.
Okay, so earlier I didn't mention I didn't give details on the pepper soup spice.
Oh, okay.
So this is a blend of different pepper soup spices that you might want to use. So we have the uziza seed, the uda, the ehoro. I don't know what they're called in English, but...
Ehoro is local nutmeg that
Thank
I
you.
Know.
Thank
yes,
you.
And that's because I recently used it to make nkobi.
Wow, yes.
Yes.
So also, I usually like to use ginger for my pepper soup. But I went to the market yesterday, I couldn't find
ginger?
Yes.
Oh, that's a must-have
yes,
for me.
Yes, hey, ginger is really, really scarce now, and wow. I hear it's really, really expensive.
Ooh.
So that's why you're not seeing it.
I guess the dry season has something to do with that.
I think so, and then cost of transportation. So, you know, cost of everything is affecting one thing.
So here, people, you hear when they were telling us that we should be planting in our backyard.
Yes, very, very important.
This is another reminder.
I don't have space to plant.
Yeah, but then you can use buckets, actually. You can use, small buckets. So I don't think, regardless of whatever space you're in, there are no excuses.
True,
if you really want to do it, you would do it.
True.
You could, literally plant in, small buckets and all of that. You can find more details online. If you're really interested, I think it's time that you did that, you know.
Okay.
And so, yeah.
So, I like to work with lots of onions for my pepper soup. Some people will just want, some persons might want to use just one.
Okay.
I like onions in my food. Mm. I don't know, it gives it this, I don't know what it gives, but it gives it.
It gives.
It gives. It keeps giving.
Yeah.
So, for this pepper, like I said earlier, it's local hot pepper. You find it the market where they sell soup ingredients. It's not the usual atarodo, not the usual scotch bonnet that we use. Mm. It's really, really hot. And you don't want to go overboard with it because it is hot, I tell you. Very hot.
Does it have a name?
Habanero pepper. But local habanero pepper.
Okay, so when you're going to buy it...
Oh, it says saint pepper. In the market, they call it saint pepper.
Because I'm like...
And then the smell.
Mm.
Don't worry. MM will tell you, guys, after...
Yeah, when the pepper soup is ready, not now. Because right now I can't smell anything. I'm not even going to lie.
So, I am using crayfish because crayfish just gives your pepper soup this balance and helps with thickening the soup. So, then the plantain, I'm sorry. The plantain, you can opt it for your sweet potatoes, your yam, whatever. It just helps to thicken your pepper soup.
Yeah, and then you have the leaves. So, we have the utazi and the...
Of course, there's no pepper soup without the scent leaf.
Scent leaf, yes.
You might want to... Do something about it,
Okay, so we're going to start cooking in a bit. Blossom is just prepping the ingredients and making sure that... Because, I mean, there's a one-pot dish. Everything is just literally going in, but we're not doing this without you. But, however, we have to head over to the couch for some nutrition discussion with Winfrey.
It is World Dietitian Day, and today, Oshun Sonya Olajumoke will be telling us who... nutritionists and dietitians really are and why we need them in our lives. Welcome back to Wake Up Nigeria.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
How are you doing today?
I'm fine.
Okay, so now you were telling me that nutritionists and dietitians are not the same. Who would have known? But then again, I mean, your bio literally reads nutrition and dietitian, right? So please, can you break it down? Let us know. Who is a dietitian and who is a nutritionist?
Okay. So I address myself as a registered dietitian nutritionist.
Okay.
Right? That means that I'm a nutritionist, but I'm also a dietitian.
All right.
So it's so good to know. I must point out that all dietitians are nutritionists, but not all nutritionists are dietitians.
Okay, so now help us define it. Let us know. Who is a nutritionist? Let's start with that.
So the title nutritionist should originally be used for graduates of nutrition and dietetics. That means that you're a graduate, you have a 4-year degree course in nutrition and dietetics. But now many things are not regulated.
Okay.
So we have many people that will probably do a few courses.
Course, yes,
in nutrition
and then call
and
themselves
say, I'm a nutritionist.
I'm a nutritionist.
Right? So
okay.
Actually, the title is meant for people who are graduates of nutrition and dietetics.
Okay.
Now, for registered dietitians, it means that after that first degree in nutrition and dietetics, they moved ahead to have 1 year clinical experience, supervised 1 year clinical experience, and they write a national exam to become a registered dietitian. They register with a regulatory body in Nigeria. So dietitians all over the world have regulatory agencies in their countries, and they are registered with them. Then they have license, just like doctors, to practice.
To practice.
Yes.
Amazing.
So every year you keep renewing your license to practice.
Okay.
So if you don't continue in education to maintain your license, you might not be able to practice for long. So you keep, you're a part of a body. Mm-hmm. You keep registering, you keep renewing your license every year to practice.
Every, amazing. So you went to school and studied
nutrition
and
dietetics, then have 1 year clinical experience, write the national exam.
Is it a professional something?
Yes, yes.
And it's amazing because now I know a lot of people who literally just, they read about fruits, read about vegetables, okay, take this one. Okay, they create maybe like a diet plan for people. And from there, they are nutritionists or dietitian. I didn't know like there was literally a, so now tell me, so the study of nutritionist, as we went to school to study, right? What was the course really about?
The course is about studying about food, all the basics, the science about food. Mm. Then you now learn about how to translate that scientific knowledge into practical dietary advice. Also, dietitians are the only health professionals qualified to treat disease with diet. Ooh. That's what we call diet therapy.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
So dietitians are the only ones that are qualified to treat disease with diet.
So there are people that
working alongside with doctors.
Working alongside with doctors. That actually makes a whole lot of sense. Because I know a lot of people who would rather go the natural routes to treat that as opposed to going to, a medical clinic. Yeah, I mean, at least you could try taking this for this. I know there are normal like home remedies for certain pains and aches and things like this. This is actually
now
amazing.
That, of course, people can browse that on Google and easily, get out some. And like I said, a lot of people can do a few courses in nutrition, probably from any international university, and probably 3-month course because they have passion for and then they can easily say, I'm a nutritionist. But professionally, this is what it means. It means that you have a degree in nutrition and dietetics. Okay. And if you want to be called a dietitian, you have to do 1 year clinical internship. Mm-hmm. Then afterwards, write the exam, be registered with that body,
with that
agency.
Oh, amazing.
The regulatory agency.
Okay, so for you, was that something you did? Did you go to school to study because you wanted to, you really were in love with it? Or something you just did and then later realized that, okay. I actually like what I'm doing here.
Oh, well, for Nigerians, most of us probably just get a course. Mm-hmm. And then by the time you're fully into the course, you'll be like, okay. Maybe I can make something out of this.
Okay.
So for me, I was given nutrition and dietetics. Mm-hmm. I put in for biochemistry, actually. And in 200 level, something was happening, and a lecturer told us that we're going to be starting diet therapy next week. I said, what's diet therapy? That was in 200 level. Mm. So I realized that diet therapy is that aspect of medicine that help you to treat disease with food. So that interests me. And fast forward to my IT days in 3rd level, I did my IT in UCH.
Okay.
And I realized how diet is so important,
Very important.
In the treatment of patients, like diabetic patients, PCOS, cancer patients as well. So we have different departments that without nutrition, the patients would not recover, you know, speedily.
True.
And also without nutrition, there's no way you can ensure that the patient is not going to be back for readmission, right? So most of the time they refer patients to us. It was quite interesting to me, and I was like, this is what I want to do. Okay. Then a few months down the line, I lost my grandmother to diabetes. And that gave me a sense of purpose. Like, see, I'm just going to do this.
Do this and
Amazing.
So would you say in Nigeria now, in the medical field especially, that you guys are actually as accepted as the, you guys need to actually be? Would you say, okay, fine, doctors literally see the importance of your role and literally refer patients accordingly?
In government hospitals, in teaching hospitals, yes, they do see the role of dietitians. They refer patients very well in government hospitals, in teaching hospitals. But in private hospitals, no. Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, some doctors will even go ahead and say, eat this, don't eat this, instead of just referring the patient. And then the patients get confused. Mm-hmm. They don't know. You know, doctors cannot really break it down for patients. And then most of the patients, they get clueless on how to manage. For instance, diabetes.
Okay.
You know, they are not able to really understand how to eat.
Yes.
Some doctors will even say, just take beans, you'll be okay. You know, I remember when, as far back as when my grandmother was alive, doctors used to prescribe beans for diabetic patients. They just said, don't eat anything, just eat beans and all protein food. Remove all carbs from your diet.
Oh, wow.
You know, and my grandmother became frustrated and be like, see, it's something that will kill man, so let me go and die in my village.
Oh, wow.
I was in school that time, so I really did not understand what was going
fully.
On.
Yeah,
right,
yeah.
And a few months down the line, she delved into herbal substances, and so herbal use.
Mm-hmm.
And before you know it, she died.
Mm-hmm.
And till now, you know, 10 years after, doctors are still prescribing beans.
Amazing.
Doctors are still prescribing unripe plantain,
terrible.
Right?
Yeah.
And I think the problem is not embracing the
the
multidisciplinary aspect of medicine,
treating patients.
You
true,
know,
true,
know,
because
so,
it's actually a part of it.
So it's so important that doctors refer patients. And it's also very important for me to point out that dietitians are not only working in hospitals, but they also work in private practice. Like I am working in private
practice.
And we're in collaboration with hospitals as well. Dietitians work with government organizations as community dietitians as well.
Okay.
For instance, if there's any organization focused on health, you know, dietitians.
That's
can be
actually
part
where. Okay.
As
amazing.
Community dietitians.
I would love to continue this conversation. It's actually very important to actually know this. Maybe next week we'll actually talk about this before we talk about the topic, because it's actually very interesting. We also even need to know how important you guys are, even to personal, like our personal lives, and having you guys on board. Thank you so much for being
You're
with
welcome.
Us. We have to go on a quick break now, and when we come back, still so much more happening here on Wake Up Nigeria.
Just like the tag, be beautiful, be like Winfrey.
Wow.
Welcome to the second hour of Wake Up Nigeria. It's been 1 hour so far. If you just joined us, you've missed one full hour, but not to worry. We'll do our best to ensure that the next 45 minutes are going to be the best for this morning.
Yes, of course. The first hour was just, it was just the right thing you needed to kickstart your morning. But then again, thanks for joining us now. Right now, let's kick into, the second hour. We hope, it's definitely going to be, it's not a hope.
Considering that Blossom, and Blossom, I don't know, is cooking up his thumb, because I don't see MM's hands are not dirty. She's not getting her hands into that thing. Blossom is the one doing all the work there. We're looking forward to what they have ready for us when they are done this morning, quite there in the kitchen. We're looking forward to all of that on the show this morning. Now, you can hit us up on social media. It's TVC Entertainment _. That's on X, LinkedIn, Facebook, and of course, Instagram.
Yes, of course. And just make sure you sit tight, right? grab whatever you can grab. It should be cold. It shouldn't be hot because the weather is hot. And definitely, we still have so much more coming up right here. My name is Winfrey Agbeleche.
I'm Mike Messi Kennel. We're going to kick off with
Eloho Efemena, who is a certified clinical counselor and mental health coach. Eloho actively works to build the self-worth and esteem of young girls and women, enduring fear, shame, and guilt due to past or present sexual, verbal, or physical abuse. She'll be here having a conversation with us, talking about the effects of negative marriage, negative effects of a broken marriage on children, and how to handle it.
And we are back.
Thanks for staying with us, guys.
Yes, Chef Blossom is still here. As you can see, we're in high spirits because we are making catfish pepper soup. Right. I'm not going to take the shine of her. I'm not going to take the credit of her because she's the one actually making it. So
Yes.
But we'll run through the ingredients once again. Okay. And then you tell us where we at.
So in here, we have our star ingredients, which is our catfish pepper soup. Mm. We have some grated peppers. I like to call it local scent peppers. And some half-ripe plantains to give it some sweetening. And then we have some onions, chopped onions as well. Grated onions, or you can substitute that for chopped onions.
Let's talk about how you wash your catfish.
Very important.
Because it requires a special skill. Yes, it actually does. If you're very familiar with catfish, you know that just washing it alone with water is not enough. Mm-hmm. You have to, how do you wash yours though?
So I like to make it very simple. I use my line.
Uh-huh.
To scrub the body
of the fish.
Yes, then I put some water.
Hot water.
Okay. Not warm. Because warm water won't really give you that effect you want. So you want it to squeeze it all in. Mm. Then you see the whole slimy, whatever, coming out from the body. You can use alum as well
to wash it.
But I hear it's not...
It's not exactly healthy. It's not a healthy alternative.
Lime, lemon. Lime is good, not lemon, please. The very small one, lime, is good.
I think you could also still use lemon because at the end of the day, what you're trying to get off it, it's get from it, it's the activity.
Imagine do you know how much you sell lemon? Please, lime. If you mind, lemon.
Blossom should not be on this show. She's a constant. She's a constant reminder of our economic realities right now. And trust me, a lot of people don't want to be reminded. They just want to eat good food, right?
The good thing is that you can buy lime and still have extra. But lemon, you buy one. For me, so like me, half of the lemon will go into my mouth. So I don't want to waste resources.
So
what we have. Yeah. So we have a blend of spices for the pepper soup spice.
Yeah.
You can use any pepper soup.
Did you make this or you got it?
Okay. You can make your pepper soup spice yourself. Yes, you can. You can just buy, pick a random.
Yeah, and just blend them all together.
Dry.
Great.
So one of our star ingredients too, we have our scent leaf pepper soup without scent leaf. Some persons might want to differ, but I cannot have my pepper soup without catfish, without scent leaf. Also, I have my utazi leaf. Utazi leaves help give the balance, you know, to the soup, help reduce the sweetness. I mean, just give it a very,
just
very
gives
nice.
It a good balance, basically. So, if there's anything that I love the most about pepper soup or this particular recipe is the ingredients, that's the scent leaf, the utazi, and the pepper soup spice. And that's because they're packing on a lot of nutrients. Utazi, scent leaf, they have a lot of nutritional benefits. One of it's they're antioxidants, and then they're mostly good for the heart, they're good for your skin. They're also good for basically your heart health generally. So I think try not to be generous with it, especially with utazi. Yeah, because you don't want it to, you know, just override the entire taste, you know, of the pepper soup. So the fish is coming together.
Yes, so I was going to get you to know how I started with the...
Oh, sure, go ahead.
So for every protein, I like to say you allow your protein cook first before adding anything
to
it. So it brings out the water or the oil, whatever it's put in there. So it just gives you that extra flavor.
So did you put in any water?
No water,
just seasoning.
Yes, just. Okay. So after having the
fish, extract the water. Mm. I added some pepper and onions just for to give it that base.
Okay.
So I'm going to add in some water now for the pepper soup, like the amount of water I will need for the soup.
Okay. That's a lot of water. So when we add in the water, what's going in next?
So once we add in the water, we will then put everything, all our spices, the crayfish, seasoning, the crayfish, everything goes in. Because it's a one-pot dish, so you can decide to put anything before.
Yeah. And then earlier on, you talked about other proteins. I'm not talking about the fish, I'm talking about the other thickness that we could use. Mm-hmm. You mentioned sweet potatoes.
Yes.
Yam.
You can use what else now?
I think you could also eat it with rice, really.
Yes. So I saw, I think for Intercontinental, they serve pepper soup with bread rolls.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
So if
you
like it,
please.
Do you. Food is whatever you make of it.
Yeah. But now, come to think of it, I was about to say not agege bread, and then I remember that there are some agege breads that,
those fluffy,
my world,
agege bread.
The ones that just got out of the oven, like oven fresh agege bread. You just have this with your pepper soup. It is going to be cooling. You already know, guys, I can't help myself when it comes to good food. And I love to be adventurous when it comes to food.
Yeah.
Well, and that's one of the things that, you know, being on the show has really taught me. You know, just spread your wings and fly. Yeah. You know, don't limit yourself when it comes to food. Yeah, be creative. Just eat.
Sometimes when making my pepper soup, I add spring onions. I blend it with the pepper. Yes.
Okay, so when I was talking about being creative,
spring onions. You can use your
spring onions.
Your chili yes.
Okay, that's a new one.
Whatever works. Some people I've seen someone use the green bell pepper.
Ah.
Yes. Anything that would give a very good result.
Yeah, give it a good taste.
Go ahead.
Right.
Go ahead and use it.
So you know, you actually just reminded me of someone that probably used cinnamon. She uses cinnamon to cook everything.
Is it a stick or the powder?
I don't even know which one she uses, but I know she uses cinnamon to cook everything.
Maybe the person has interest in the taste, the aftertaste.
Also, because cinnamon actually has a certain, there's a certain flavor,
but
you know, that it gives. But you need to be, on the quantity.
On the quantity.
Yeah, you don't want to use too much
overboard,
of it because,
So for this particular recipe, because we're cooking we're using catfish as a protein, you don't want to stir with your spoon.
Oh, okay. So you don't want it to, dissipate. Like, you don't want it to scatter.
Scatter, But so what you just give it a shake.
You don't want it to break.
So you blend the whole.
Okay. So and then we just leave it to cook.
Leave it to cook.
For how long? How long is it going to cook for?
Catfish is supposed to cook for 20 minutes. Mm. Some persons tell you, oh, isn't those catfish to get too soft? Mm. You need to allow your protein cook properly.
Mm. And then you also want all that ingredients to go into the fish and the plantains or whatever it is that you're using for your pepper soup. We need all that flavor so that as you're taking each spoon.
So I'll be adding my seasoning now.
Cubes, okay. Ah, that's a good amount of seasoning cubes. Okay.
Just a few of it.
So no, I like I'm not questioning. Please, go ahead.
I like to use my... So someone asked me, I think one of my friends visited me when I was cooking the house, and she said, Tosom, I didn't see you use salt to cook
Yeah.
I'm like, why are people abusing...
Salt, really?
Salt is meant to taste, not to cook. You can argue with your...
With your Google.
Salt is not for cooking.
Yeah.
Salt is made. They always say salt to taste.
So when you Blossom.
When you use salt to cook, you don't need to add crayfish because salt has a whole and taste on its own.
And then you also need to be cautious. I mean, health experts are always, you know, advising us our use of salt because of the quantity of the sodium in it. So you want to be careful because you don't want too much of it in your body.
So after having all these ingredients go in, you already know that you should have a particular level of taste that will come with the food. Because the fish has its own taste, the crayfish has its own taste, everything has...
And let's not also forget that the seasoning cubes or the whatever seasoning you're using also has a high volume of sodium in it as well. Yeah. So you really need to be cautious with it.
Yes.
So our spice is going in as well. Okay.
So the reason I didn't open this, you don't want the flavor to spread out.
Ah, okay.
is?
Freelance.
Like when diffusion.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Nice. Also it. So if you have,
so you keep it in a
Airtight container. If you have a pepper soup ingredient in the house, or pepper soup spice, sorry, after blending them, make sure you put it in an airtight container so the whole scent doesn't.
Okay. Great stuff. We've learned so much here on the show. I hope you have as well. And if you're watching right now and you're drooling, well, all you just need to do is go and make your own pepper soup.
Or patronize Blossom Sport, please.
Yes, or patronize her. You can find her on Instagram and on all
at
socials
Blossom's
as well.
Yeah,
we have to go on a quick break now. The show continues shortly. Stay with us.
And our final guest this morning is a certified clinical counselor and mental health coach, Eloho Efemina. It's great to have you. You're welcome.
Hi, Mike. Morning again.
All right, this is a good time having you this month. And we're talking about the effect of divorce or separation, as it were, on children. Now, we know that we're not talking about the rate, but we know that the rate of separation and divorce is quite high. I mean, the last time we spoke about I think
self-awareness,
and then if you've already made a decision, you know. But then some people get to realize after they've made a decision, and then they feel that it is in their best interest to either separate or divorce, and there's nothing wrong with that. But then, in a case where kids are involved now, you now have to start thinking about mentally how to raise them and ensure that this does not have effect. It's quite hard. I mean, a lot of people have spoken about that. We know that the family is the basic building block of society.
Exactly.
How is it possible, especially in the case where, you know, differences, they're living apart, living separately. At times there is a custody battle, which at times even gets ugly.
Messy, yeah.
And then there are even times, there are even situations where there is no custody battle, and maybe one parent just decides to shirk their responsibilities and not even do anything. Many instances of all of this.
So many.
But how best can parents raise kids in this particular scenario?
So I will say that you have to be honest with your children. You know, in this part of the world, we don't really see the need for counseling for children, you know, child and adolescent, because we have child and adolescent counseling.
Okay.
You know, where, yes, when your parents are going through this phase in their lives, the children are supposed to go through counseling, help them understand the situation. And if you cannot afford therapy for now, there are some things you can also do. Have honest conversations with them.
What if they're too young?
Okay, that's the thing. You know, divorce actually affects the child, that's before a teenager. When you're trying to address a teenager, it's different from addressing a child.
A child, yeah.
Yeah, teenagers can kind of understand, but people neglect the child and feel that she's still small now. She might not understand. She will understand, because you can start giving her some unconscious thoughts. She may feel that, when I was, daddy and mommy were calling my name and they were quarreling, maybe I'm the cause of this particular, you know, separation. And the child start blaming themselves. And when they grow up, they start, you know, having this unconscious thought again that maybe marriage is not for me. And they start acting some type of way. And you wonder, why is this child acting this way? Because of the confusion he or she has seen growing up. So it's very important that as you're paying attention to a teenager, pay attention to a child also, and have honest conversations. As a child is growing, have conversations. See, the reason that why daddy and mommy are living apart is because of this. We love you. We love you. Don't, you know, it doesn't change anything about you. It's not about you. It's just us. You know, honest conversations are very important in this this phase of life.
But, you know, in a case where we've seen where even in society where people have, in quotes, weaponized children in such a way that, so I'm having issues with the mother or the father, and then the children get to suffer. I mean, I've seen a case where irresponsible men will come and say, oh, if the mother doesn't come back, I'm not going to pay for the school fees for the kids. Your own children?
Terrible.
Your own children? Gross irresponsibility, ineptitude. Let's not even, that one, there's no even need to ask Eloho, why
that something's wrong with you.
As a man, you know, as a man. You know, but we also have cases where even women weaponize children. You know, it's not a gender thing. It's not a gender thing. It happens both male and female. In those kind of scenarios, what would you have to say?
The thing is, Mike, you see, I usually say something. Marriage is good. It's the two people involved that have problem. You know, if a father is using the child as a weapon against the mother, or the mother, you know, vice versa, you know that these two people, they have problem. So if the authorities can come in this particular case, there is when you know, in civilized world, no, sorry, developed world.
Yes.
Permit me. You can see social workers. They can't pick that child because the parents are not doing well.
Very true.
But where we are right now, we don't.
Where you are so irresponsible and you shouldn't have had a child.
Exactly.
You are a child yourself.
You are having a child. Can imagine.
In that kind of scenario.
That's what
you cannot.
These days.
Yes.
A child having a child. They are not matured in their mind.
And it's not about age. It's not about age.
It's not about age.
You have some very, very, very old children and all of that. Well, it's not about age,
not about
you know.
Age.
So in that, like you said, but do we have access to social services? Let me not just assume.
In Nigeria here. I can't say.
I also can't say because as far as I know, it doesn't. It doesn't happen.
Maybe, but in this, I'm not saying.
But in this scenario, where can one go to the court of law to, you know, to enforce some sort of responsibility from a particular, maybe from a father or something to the children, if that particular parent is capable. I know that it's possible that one can do that, right?
To you're legally married. You're legally married, right? Yeah. You have right to your children, both the father and the mother. Mm. And you know that your spouse is, you know, trying to, you know, use the children against you. You can actually petition your spouse. I'm not doing it again. That doesn't mean that you will now start, you know, misbehaving or start using the children against me. The court should be able to petition that particular spouse that you have to stop doing this or we are going to sign or, you know, file something against you. So, of course, you can do that.
So most of the time, the kids are mostly with the mother, yes. But then we also even have cases of where the kids are with the father. And I know that in each scenario, it's not, they are unique. A father raising a kid or kids is different from a mother raising them. In those particular scenarios, what would you say? Okay, let's talk about a father, a single father. Mm. Maybe something has happened, the mother is not available or something, and then the father has to raise the kids. Mm. How best can a father create an environment for the children to
grow? Mike, that is a very, very important question because a child cannot just be solely raised by one parent. It's very difficult.
It is, but
yeah,
but
look, you have to have.
It happens.
Yes, what you
a lot. So a lot of people that today that are even good enough were raised by one parent. You know, it's circumstances.
Yes.
It will happen.
Yes, you know what you can do at that point is to have either a mother figure for that child.
Mm.
Yes. And if it's the woman, have a father figure. I'm not saying you should have to be your boyfriend or something because that can confuse children. Like, daddy and mommy are not together and I'm seeing mommy with another guy or I'm seeing daddy with another guy. This child should know that this person is my mentor. Okay, let me use that word. But a father or a mother figure because a man has a role to play in his daughter's life as well as the mother. And in a child, in a son's life, the mother has a role also as much as the father. So you need to have both roles, the father and the mother. So if you don't have a father, a wife right now, or you don't have a husband right now, have a father figure or a mother figure. If it's somebody that you look up to, please help me mentor this child. I cannot do it by myself. Mm. You understand? Because that particular space will be lacking. So you need a father figure, a mother figure for that child.
All right. I'm not fully satisfied. I wish we had more time. Because of time. Because of it's so wide.
People should talk about it next
so
time.
Well. Yes, we'll probably continue on a part two. We've spoken about it well so far. What I mean is that there are more questions to ask because of, you know, everything that you say would lead to more questions. But thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
And because of that, we have breakfast for you. Oh, you're fasting now. Hello is fasting, so don't worry. We're not coming to the kitchen.
Stop, Mike.
We just have to end the show now. Hello fasting.
I want to eat.
You know it's Lent.
Oh.
At the same time, drama does. So
why
you have to choose one.
Why did you call the food at first? Why?
Yeah. All right. We have to head over to the kitchen now, and of course, Ella will be joining us today.
Thank you.
Welcome to the kitchen, Eloho.
Thank you.
This is Chef Blossom. Yes, and this Chef morning, E. She's made for you catfish pepper soup. I see that you're already longing for it.
Know,
so we're not going to waste any time. We'll just get right into it. So here you go. I know you got here really early.
Yes.
So this is a perfect start to your day.
Thank you.
Go
Thank
ahead.
You, Chef Blossom.
She said she's not fasting.
No, she said
you wouldn't want the Lord to eat this food.
For now, she's not
Maybe
fasting.
After she's had it, then she
wouldn't want the Lord to eat this food. Eh?
Wow. It's not so good.
Yes, it actually does.
I like scintillating.
No, you do. Okay. So get okay.
Nice, be nice.
Thank you.
And I love planting.
Oh, you do. Nice. Well done, Blossom.
Thank you, Blossom.
Well, you're welcome.
And thanks for the sacrifice. I know you went a long way. It took so much from you to buy catfish for us. Thank you so much.
Amazing. And thanks to everyone that joined us today on the show. And to you watching us. It was definitely an amazing time on this Wednesday edition. But don't forget, tomorrow we have Artsy Thursday. So make sure you do stay tuned. Keep it locked right here, all right? Don't touch that dial. We'll be back tomorrow.
Bye.
What's Mike? Mike, what are you looking at?